We were asked to evaluate each expression for the given values. To evaluate an algebraic expression, we first substitute the given values for the variables, and then we evaluate or simplify the given expression using the order of operations. For number one, we're given the expression 2x minus 5. We're asked to evaluate this when x equals negative 6. For the first step, we substitute negative 6 for x, and because 2x means 2 times x, performing substitution gives us the expression 2 times negative 6 minus 5. Following the order of operations, we multiply before subtracting. 2 times negative 6 equals negative 12. This simplifies to negative 12 minus 5. Negative 12 minus 5 is equal to negative 17. The expression is equal to negative 17 when x equals negative 6. Now, if it's helpful, we could have written this difference here as a sum. Subtracting positive 5 is equivalent to adding negative 5, and therefore negative 12 minus 5 is equivalent to negative 12 plus negative 5, which does give us negative 17. For number 2, we have the expression 4 divided by the quantity 5t minus 4, which we want to evaluate when t equals 4. So we substitute 4 for t, which gives us the expression 4 divided by the quantity 5 times 4 minus 4. We need to be careful here. We cannot simplify these 4s or these 4s because we cannot simplify across addition or subtraction. When we have a fraction, we treat this as if we have grouping symbols around the numerator and denominator, and therefore the next step is to simplify the denominator. In the denominator, we have multiplication and subtraction. We multiply first. So we have 4 divided by the quantity 5 times 4 is equal to 20. The denominator simplifies to the quantity 20 minus 4. 20 minus 4 is equal to 16, and therefore this simplifies to 4 sixteenths, which does simplify because 4 and 16 share a common factor of 4. To simplify, we divide the numerator and denominator by 4. 4 divided by 4 equals 1. 16 divided by 4 is equal to 4. The expression is equal to 1/4 when t equals 4. The next expression is 2/3 times, the next expression is 2/3 pi r squared h, which we want to evaluate when r equals 3 and h equals 7. So we substitute 3 for r and 7 for h. This gives us the expression 2/3 times pi times the square of 3 times 7. The first step is to simplify the exponents. 3 squared is equal to 3 times 3, which equals 9. So we have 2/3 pi times 9 times 7. And now we multiply, but before multiplying, we can simplify because 3 and 9 share a common factor of 3. As a fraction, 9 times 7 has a denominator of 1. And now simplifying, there's 1, 3, and 3, and 3 threes and 9. Multiplying, we have 2 times pi times 3 times 7. And because 2 times 3 times 7 is equal to 42, we write this product as 42 pi. The given expression is equal to 42 pi when r equals 3 and h equals 7. We often use 3.14 as an approximation for pi, but because we want the exact value of the expression, we leave this in terms of pi. The next expression is a squared plus 2ab plus b squared, which we want to evaluate when a equals negative 3 and b equals 6. Performing this substitution, a squared would be the square of negative 3. We do need parentheses around the negative 3 because we want two factors of negative 3. Then we have plus 2 times a times b, which is 2 times negative 3 times 6, plus b squared, which is the square of 6. The next step is to simplify the exponents. Being careful here, the square of negative 3 means negative 3 times negative 3, which is positive 9. Then we have plus 2 times negative 3 times 6, plus 6 squared is equal to positive 36. Next we multiply, so we have 9 plus 2 times negative 3 times 6 equals negative 36. So we have plus negative 36, which we can also write as just minus 36, and then plus 36. The last step is to add. Notice here we're adding opposites, so this sum is 0. This is 9 plus 0, which equals 9. We're adding from left to right. 9 plus negative 36 equals negative 27. Negative 27 plus 36 equals positive 9.
The last expression is the square root of 5a squared bc.
We want to evaluate this when a equals 2, b equals 5, and c equals 1. Performing the substitution gives us the expression the square root of 5 times the square of 2 times 5 times 1. Simplifying under the square root, we first simplify the exponents. 2 squared is equal to 2 times 2, which equals 4. So we have the square root of 5 times 4 times 5. We don't need the times 1, but let's go ahead and leave it there. Next, we multiply under the square root. 5 times 4 times 5 times 1 is equal to 100. The square root of 100 simplifies perfectly to 10. The square root of 100 is equal to 10 because 10 squared equals 100. I hope you found this helpful.